Now let's talk about the third keyword we've seen, the OR logic. The OR logic has the following truth table. Imagine two inputs, A and B. A can be either true or false. The A or B is true as long as one of the two inputs are true. For example, if A is false and B is false, A or B is false. If either A is true or B is true, then the output A or B is true. So the OR logic basically means one of the inputs is true. There's a circuit for a two-input OR logic gate. Now for our expression where we had lights is equal to motion and not bright OR switch, the processing logic for this can be drawn as following. The inputs are motion, bright, and switch, and the output is lights. And the circuit can be drawn as the following with a combination of a NOT gate and the AND gate that we saw in the previous video and the OR gate that we are just seeing right now. So motion is motion ANDed with NOT bright. So bright goes through a NOT gate to produce NOT bright, gets ANDed by this AND gate to produce motion AND NOT bright. That goes into one of the inputs of the OR gate. The other input of the OR gate is connected to the input called switch. So the OR gate is doing switch or motion and not bright to produce lights. So that's the processing system that goes in here for this particular expression. Now, for this particular expression, let's consider the truth table. Remember, truth table is a enumeration of all possible combinations for the input and the outputs. So here there are three inputs, motion, bright, and switch. And the output is called lights. So let's see what all possible scenarios we have. So for example, consider the case where it's not bright outside. So bright is false, there's no movement, false, and the switch, manual switch, is also false. So in this case, we do not need to turn on the lights, so lights are false. Now it's not bright outside, meaning it's dark outside, and there's no motion, so there's no need to turn on the light, but this manual switch is turned on. So in this case, because of this expression, switch is true, our lights expression comes out to be true. Now here it is. It's dark outside, meaning it's not bright, but there's motion. So if it's not bright and that there's motion, we need to have the lights turned on even if the manual switch was off. So this lights are turned on because there was movement and it was not bright outside. Then we have a case where it's dark outside, there's motion outside, and the switch is also turned on. So both this set of conditions and this set of conditions are true. So true or true produces a true. Now for the next four cases, we are going to have bright outside. So true. So it's always bright outside. So we don't care what the motion sensor says, because if it's bright outside, it doesn't matter if there's movement. We don't want the light on. So the only time we should have the light on is if the switch is manually turned on. So we see that in these four cases where it's bright outside, the only time lights are on is if the switch is true. So switch is true, lights are true. Switch is true, lights are true. Okay. So this enumerates every single possible scenario of this logical expression. To quickly summarize now, we can go from word problems to circuits using NOT, OR, and keywords. NOT inverts the input to the opposite value. So if it's true, then we produce an output of false. So here is the logic symbol or a circuit symbol for NOT. If we want to write this algebraically, we write that A with a bar over it to represent NOT in Boolean. We call it the Boolean expression. A or B is written as A, this is plus, is actually called an OR, and that's a circuit. OR gate produces a true if either input is true. And finally, the AND gate produces a true if both inputs are true, and that's a logic circuit for AND. and we write it as a dot b, or sometimes simply as ab. So quickly recap, this is called Boolean algebra. Boolean algebra is basically used to describe any logical calculations that a computer draws that has the values of either true or false. Basic operations we've seen so far are AND, OR, and NOT logic gates. And based pretty much any logical expression can be represented by these three operations. Logical expressions are things such as A or B, or not light or motion, and so forth. The truth table that we saw for the AND, OR, and NOT is what's called a truth table because it had true and false scenarios written on it. Sometimes true is referred to as 1 and false is referred to as 0. So instead of writing long words like false and true, we sometimes write the truth table in forms of ones and zeros, where true means 1 and false means a 0. So here's the AND gate. 0, 0 produces a 0. So false, false produces a false. True, true produces a true. So 1, 1 produces a 1. In the case of a NOT, a 0 produces a 1. A 1 produces a 0. So these are called logic 0 and logic 1. 1 basically means true. 0 means false.